Good morning, all of you. So yesterday we have discussed about the refractory compressor and we have seen one numerical on respirating compressor. So today we'll continue our numericals. Again, whatever numerical yesterday we have seen, so first we'll practice similar numericals and then we'll proceed some another type of numericals. Now this is the statement of second numerical. So a single stage reciprocating air compressor has cylinder diameter and stroke of 200 millimeter and 300 millimeter respectively. The compressor takes air at 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius and delivers at 8 bar while running at 100 rpm. Find first indicated power of the compressor. Second, mass of air delivered by the compressor per minute, and third, temperature of air delivered by the compressor. The compression follows the law PV raised to 1.25 is equal to C, and take characteristic gas constant as 287 joule per kg per Kelvin. Now the statement is similar to previous numerical. Only difference is that they have given additional two parameters. First is cylinder diameter, which is 200 millimeter, and stroke of the cylinder 300 millimeter. Rest of the parameters are as previous. So the pressure P1 is 1 bar. Again, we have to convert this pressure from bar to Pascal. Then temperature T1 is 27 degrees Celsius. Again, we have to convert this temperature from degree Celsius to degree Kelvin. Pressure P2 is 8 bar. Again, we have to convert this pressure from bar to Pascal. Again, speed is given, it is 1000 rpm. again, we have to find similar parameters. Again, the law of compression is PV raised to 1.25 is equal to C. again, the polytropic index is 1.25 and the characteristic gas constant is 287 joule per kg per Kelvin. So we'll proceed as per the previous numerical. So let us see the solution for this numerical. The data of the numerical as discussed. So D is the diameter of the cylinder, which is 200 millimeter. It is converted into meter. Again, stroke L, it is 300 millimeter. It is converted from millimeter to meter. So it is 0.3 meter. Then pressure P1, it is 1 bar. It is converted from bar to Pascal. So 1 bar is equal to 1 into 10 to 5 Pascal or 1 into 10 to 5 Newton per meter square. Then temperature T1, 27 degrees Celsius, again it is converted to degree Kelvin. So 27 plus 273, it is 300 degree Kelvin. Then pressure P2, 8 bar, again we have to convert this from bar to Pascal. So pressure P2 is 8 into 10 to 5 Pascal or 8 into 10 to 5 Newton per meter square. Capital N, speed, it is 100 rpm. Then polytropic index N, it is 1.25. And characteristic gas constant is 287 joule per kg per Kelvin. So first, we have to use the basic relation. In previous numerical, directly they have given the volume V1, but instead of that volume, they have given diameter and stroke. So from that, we can calculate volume V1 by the relation, pi, V1 is equal to pi by 4 D square into L. So substitute value of D, again substitute value of L, and by calculation, we'll get the volume V1, it is 0.0094 meter cube. Then we have to use the relation for indicated work in terms of n, n minus 1, p1, v1, p2 by p1, n minus 1 by n minus 1. Again, small n is 1.25, p1 is 1 into 10 to the 5, v1 just we have calculated, it is 0.0094, p2 is 8 into 10 to the 5, substitute value of p2 and p1, again small n, and when we calculate, then accordingly the value of indicated power is 2425 Newton meter. Again, speed of the compressor is given. So from that speed we can find the work in kilowatt. So it is 2425 into 100 by 60. So the same work from Newton meter we can write in kilowatt. considering the speed, that is 100 rpm. Then again, in order to find mass of the air delivered, we have to use general gas equation, that is P1 V1 is equal to MRT1. So again, from this equation we can write small m is equal to P1 V1 upon RT1. So value of P1 is 1 × 10⁵ Pascal, V1 is just calculated 0.0094, R is 287, it is given in the statement of the problem, and T1 is 300 degree Kelvin. So when we substitute the values and when we calculate, the mass of the air is given, it is 0.0109 kilogram per stroke. Then again, since speed is given to us, so this is per stroke, so considering the speed we can write mass into that speed, so the mass will be 0.0109 × 100, so it is 1.09 kilogram. The temperature of the air delivered, so for that we have to use the relation between pressure ratio and temperature ratio. So it is T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 raised to n minus 1 by n. So we know the temperature T1, again we know the pressure P2, we know the pressure P1, again we know the value of small n. So when we substitute this value, then we can write here temperature T2 in degree Kelvin, it is 181.8 degree Kelvin. So this is the solution for this numerical. Now let us proceed. This is the statement of the numerical. An air compressor takes in air at 1 bar and 20 degrees Celsius and compresses it according to the law PV raised to 1.2 is equal to constant. It is then delivered to a receiver at constant pressure of 10 bar. Again, value of characteristic gas constant, that is capital R, is 0.287 kilojoule per kg per Kelvin. So determine temperature at the end of compression, work done and heat transferred during compression per kilogram of air. Now this statement is similar to previous statement, only difference is that we have to find one more parameter, that is heat transferred during compression. Again, we know how to find temperature, again work done or indicated power as previous, only additional term that we have to determine, that is heat transferred. So in order to find this heat transferred during compression, again we have to use first law of thermodynamics. So according to first law of thermodynamics, we will find this heat transfer during compression. So let us proceed for the solution. First we have to write the given data. So this P1, pressure P1 is 1 bar, temperature T1 is 20 degrees Celsius. Again, the law of compression is PV raised to 1.2 is equal to constant. So value of polytropic index small n is 1.2. Again, pressure P2 is 10 bar and characteristic gas constant R is 0.287 kilojoule per kg per Kelvin. So this is the given data of the same numerical. Temperature T1, it is converted from degree Celsius to degree Kelvin. So 20 plus 273, it is 293 Kelvin. Pressure P1, 1 bar. Pressure P2, 10 bar. Again, law of compression is PV raised to 1.2 is equal to C. So small n is 1.2. R is 287 joule per kg per Kelvin. Now again, to find the temperature T2, we have to use the relation between temperature ratio and pressure ratio. So T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 raised to n minus 1 by n. Substitute value of temperature T1, value of P2 and P1. So value of P2 is 10, P1 is 1, temperature T1, it is 293. So from that we can write the temperature T2 in degree Kelvin is 430 degree Kelvin or 157 degree Celsius. Now again, to find the work, so to find indicated power, again we have to use the relation work is equal to n upon n minus 1 MRT1 P2 by P1 raised to n minus 1 by n minus 1. So substitute value of small n, again capital R, T1, and since here we have calculated this value per unit mass of the air, so accordingly the work is 236.13 kilojoule per kilogram of the air. So if you calculate the mass, then we can multiply by that mass to this value, and accordingly we can find the total indicated work. Then these two calculation, that is temperature and indicated work, is similar to our previous numerical. Now we have to find heat transfer during compression. So for that we have to use the general gas equation, that is Q is equal to W plus delta U. Again, for work, that is for polytropic, considering the polytropic compression, we have the relation P1V1 minus P2V2 upon N minus 1. Again, for the delta U is the change in internal energy, it is given as CV into T2 minus T1. Again, this value we have to find for unit mass of the air. So when we substitute value of P1V1 P2V2 N, then T2 and T1, again for air, value of CV is taken as 0.718, that is kilojoule per kg per Kelvin. So when we substitute the value and when we calculate, then accordingly heat transferred is 98.23 kilojoule per kilogram. So if you know the total mass, then again we can multiply that mass to this value, and so that we will get the total heat transferred. So value of this heat transfer is negative, that indicates that the heat is rejected during this compression. Now this is the statement of the next numerical. An air compressor cylinder has 150 mm diameter and 150 mm stroke, and the clearance is 15%. It operates between 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius and 5 bar. Take polytropic exponent, small n is 1.3 for compression and expansion process. Find cylinder volume at the various points in a cycle, flow rate in meter cube per minute at 720 rpm and volumetric efficiency. Now what is the difference between the previous numerical and this numerical? So previous all numericals, whatever we have discussed, that is on reciprocating compressor without considering the clearance. Now here clearance is considered, so that is the change in this numerical. So again, process remains same, or procedure remains same as previous. Only difference is that we have to use the relation for volumetric efficiency in terms of clearance. So we know that volumetric efficiency, when we consider the clearance volume, that is capital C or capital K. So this clearance volume is, clearance factor is the ratio of clearance volume to the swept volume. So since here they have given clearance 15%, means it is a clearance factor. So clearance factor capital C or capital K, it is given, it is 15%. Again, diameter D is given, stroke 150 mm, that is capital L, this is capital D, that is diameter. Then pressure P1 is 1 bar, temperature T1 is 27 degrees Celsius, pressure P2 is 5 bar and small n is 1.3. Now in order to find the volume at various point, so we have to use the relation between various process considering the closed cycle, for, or that is PV diagram or indicated diagram of reciprocating compressor without clearance. So according to that diagram, we will find the volume at all the points considering their basic relation between the various process. Again, that is to find the flow rate, it is nothing but the free air delivered, that we have to find. Again, that is meter cube per minute considering the 720 rpm and volumetric efficiency. So let us proceed for this solution. Now this is the data of the numerical. D is given, it is 150 into 10 to 3 minus 3 meter. Capital L, 150 into 10 to minus 3 meter. Then VC is equal to 0.15 VS, this is from clearance factor. P1 is 1 into 10 to 5 Newton per meter square, P2 is 5 into 10 to 5 Newton per meter square, T1 is 27 plus 273 300 degree Kelvin, N is 720 rpm, PV raised to N is equal to that C, that's why small n is 1.3. So we have to find these four volume, V1, V2, V3, V4 and free air delivered, that is FAD, and volumetric efficiency. So we know that total volume V1 is VC plus VS. Again, we can write VS as 5 by 4 D square L into N, substitute value of D, then L and N. So when we calculate, then accordingly value of VS is 1.9085 meter cube. Again, VC is equal to 1.15 VS, that is given, substitute the value of VS, we will get need. So from that we can write the total volume V1 is equal to VC plus VS, it is 2.1948 meter cube per minute. Again, we know the relation between the process for compression during 1 to 2. So it is P1 V1 raised to n is equal to P2 V2 raised to n. So from that we can write V2 is equal to V1 in bracket P1 by P2 raised to 1 by n. So we know V1, we know P1, we know P2. When we substitute this value, then accordingly value of V2 is 0.6366 meter cube per minute. Then volume V3 is nothing but the clearance volume, so that is equal to Vc. So already we have calculated this value, so V3 is 0.2862 meter cube per minute. Then again considering the process 3 to 4, again for expansion we can write P3 V3 is to n is equal to P4 V4 is to n. So from that we can write V4 is equal to V3 is into bracket P3 by P4 1 by n. Again substitute value of V3, substitute value of P3, P4 and n, we will get the value of V4. Again we know that pressure P2 is equal to P3, it is constant pressure process. Again P1 is equal to P4, again it is constant pressure process. This is during suction, this is during the discharge. So accordingly again when we substitute the value of P3 is equal to P2 and P1 is equal to P4, so we will substitute the value of P3 is equal to P2 and P4 is equal to P1. So accordingly the same expression is written here for V4, it is V3 P2 by P1 raised to 1 by n. So accordingly when we calculate, value of V4 is 0.98674 meter cube per minute. Then volumetric efficiency, this is the relation in terms of capital K. So we have derived in terms of capital C. So capital K and capital C is same. So it is volume efficiency is 1 plus K minus K P2 by P1 raised to 1 by N. So value of K is 15%. It is a clearance factor. So already it is given. So it is 0.1499 by calculation, but it is given in the statement also. And finally, the volumetric efficiency we can write in terms of free air delivered and stress volume. It is the same formula which is converted into in terms of clearance factor. So from this equation, we can write free air delivered is equal to volumetric efficiency into Vs. So volumetric efficiency is 0.633 into 1.9085. So volumetric efficiency we have calculated by this expression. It is equal to 0.633, and from volumetric efficiency and the surge volume we are delivered as 1.2083 meter cube per minute. So these are the numericals that we have practiced. So in the next lecture we will see the similar numericals. Thank you.